What it do, people? Welcome to the Veganlicious Kitchen. Today I'm here by myself. The grand is gone. Chunga done flew back to his destination. Michi done flew up out of here to his destination. And Precious P, y'all already know, she's a runner. She's a track star. Okay? She's out and about to go. But I'm gonna hold the kitchen down by myself. Okay, so today in the Veganlicious Kitchen, 1 minute, I'm gonna need you to subscribe, like, comment, and share, okay? So today in the Veganlicious Kitchen, I am cooking Mike will be having people going. Okay, I'm cooking black bean, well, tacos, okay? Should I call them tacos? They're gonna be Mexican pockets, okay? Mexican pockets, that's what we're cooking. And inside those Mexican pockets, there's black beans. We're gonna use some vegan sausage. We're also gonna use, you know, some cheddar. I'm gonna jazz these things up and teach you something new, okay? It's a little snack that you can do for lunchtime or whenever. You can do that dinner too, but I'm doing it for lunch. So let's get this thing started. And I'm gonna get your ingredients. I'll be right back. Okay, so first ingredient, I said I was gonna stop clapping, right? First ingredient is black beans. Red bell pepper. We're gonna use that white onion today. We're gonna use a vegan fill roast sausage. We're gonna throw some salsa up in this mix. And we're gonna use taco mix. And we're gonna use some follow your heart cheddar. And we're gonna put everything that's gonna be the filling. Wait. We're gonna add some more garlic. I don't have any more than this garlic. I gotta go to store. We're gonna use some more onion. And we're gonna use some cilantro, okay? And we're gonna fill all those ingredients into our little vegan wrap, okay? So, I'm ready to start cooking. How about you? Let's get this going. I'll be back. Okay, let's get this started. But no. Rapeseed oil in. You don't need that much. Okay, very little. You don't need that much of that. Just a little bit. And put that back there. Let that heat up a little. Then we're gonna add in the white onions. Okay, let's keep sizzling. We are all in running already. Okay. That's what I'm talking about. What are we doing? I'm gonna throw in the red bell peppers. I should be using a spatula, but whatever. We're gonna let that sizzle, right? Then we're gonna put in, let's fix this up. Let's put in the fill roasted sausage. And we're gonna let that cook for a little while. A little bit, poquito, not very long. Cause again, this sausage is not meat. Okay, it is not. I repeat, not meat. So you ain't gotta worry about undercooked meat that's gonna give you worms and all types of parasites, right? So we're just gonna let that sizzle up a little bit, not very long. You're just going to combine the meat with the vegetables. Then you're going to add in just a little bit pink salt, just a little bit garlic. Well, we ain't got to do a little bit of garlic. We could do a lot because I don't have any minced garlic. So we're going to cover that thing. Then you're going to add some onion, a little bit, because we already have white onions in there. But that's okay, we can add more if you like. And we're going to throw some cilantro in there, okay? And let's mix that a little bit. Let's turn down the fire, let's turn down the fire. It just doesn't have to cook like that. Not meat. Not meat. Not meat. May I repeat, it is not meat. Okay. So now we're going to add in the taco seasoning to give you that Mexican flavor. I'm using this Mexican seasoning I got from Trader Joe's. You see it? This one is a bit spicy. Trader Joe's taco mix. Okay, it's a bit spicy. Trust me. So, if you like your Mexican food spicy, add a lot. If not, add a little bit. Okay, all in your judgment. Okay, so that's mixed up. Now we're gonna go ahead and cut that off because it doesn't need to cook anymore. Okay, that's what I'm talking about. Okay, next step. Next step coming up. Hold on. Okay, I'm back. Everything is ready to go. The filling is done. So now I'm going to show you the process of filling your wrap with the filling. So I'm going to pan down so you can see what's going on. Okay? Okay. So there's the filling. You see I added black beans to it. I just took the black beans out of the can, rinsed them off, and then dried them off and threw them in there. You really don't have to cook them because, again, the air fryer is going to cook it for you. So why are you cooking twice? This is beans and this is non-meat, okay? So there's no long process of making sure your meat is fully cooked and all that. No, we bypass these steps, okay, when you're a vegan. Meats, vegetables don't need to be cooked that long because you take all the nutrition out of them when you cook them too long. Okay, so there's my wrap. Here's my water to, you know, wet the ends of the wrap so it closes up properly. I should have put the filling in first and threw the water on it, but okay. I'm back. So we're gonna throw the meat and beans and veggies inside the wrap, right? Then we're gonna throw some cheese in there. We're gonna throw our Follow Your Heart cheddar inside the wrap. And then we're gonna, what? Hold. We're gonna make sure everything is in the wrap, fold it. There's your first row. Hold on, let me get another plate because I'm gonna need one plate to wrap and one plate to put everything on the plate. I don't have many wraps left because I use them for the non-vegan egg roll. Second wrap, same process, okay, so I don't have to show you 10 times how to do this. You should know how to do it. Put it on, boom, boom, bam, bam, put it on, right? Where's the cheese? Put the cheese on. Boop. Right? Like that. Then put the water on the edges to seal the wrap. This is like a pastry wrap. So you gotta seal it like a pocket. I already showed you. Do I need to show you again? Okay. Maybe some of y'all are a little slow. I don't know. But I'm going to show you again. Fold.
clothed. Make sure all the filling is in your envelope. Right before you close it, you make sure everything is inside. Then roll it over and boop, bam, there you go. Okay, so I'll be back to show you how they come out after they come out the air fryer. I'll be back. Okay, I'm back. I just thought of something I wanted to add into my little Mexican wrap here, and that is jalapenos, okay? So throw those jalapenos in too. They make your food pop, and they're also a superfood, okay? So if you want to add jalapenos in, go ahead and do so. I'll be back.
Okay, I'm back. So I'm about to place the rolls into the air fryer. Now, if you have spray, this is olive oil spray, you can use this on your rolls so they turn crispy, okay? Because it needs some help to get crispy, and that's where the oil comes in, okay? Last video, I think I showed y'all, I was using the grapeseed oil with the paper towel to, you know, put some oil on top of the wraps, and I just forgot that I had this, so I'm gonna use this one today. So we're gonna spray just a little bit, just a little bit, just a little bit, just a little bit. Let me place these in here. Do y'all see me doing this? Y'all get the gist of what I'm doing. Goes in here. They're all in there. Okay. Now let's put them in the air fryer. And I'll show you the finished results in a minute. Be back.
And I'm back with the finished product, okay? So let me show you how they came out. They came out popping, okay? Let me show you. Hold on. Use your forces to bring this down a little bit. So there they are. That's your Mexican wraps with black beans, filled roast sausages, onions, peppers, jalapenos, and cheddar cheese. Did I say black beans? Yeah, I did at the top. Okay, and then there goes your salsa to dip them in. And there's your avocado there on the side just to dig into it and eat it, okay? So there it is. Let me show you. Me eating them, I guess. I don't have a taste tester today, so I guess I'm my own test taster today.
Let's give praise to the man upstairs. Without him, there's no us. Here we go. Put the head down. Bow, there it is.
Okay. Let me go ahead and taste these things for y'all to let y'all know how they taste. I'm going to go ahead and dip it in my salsa. Right, get some salsa on it. It's pretty hot still, but okay. Hey. So good. Delicious. You won't regret making them. Trust and believe. If you would like a copy of my Veganlicious ebook, go down in the description box and there's the information you need to get my ebook. There's plenty of great recipes in my book. There's breakfast, there's lunch, there's dinner, and there's also snacks. There's also snacks, Rebecca. There's also snacks. So don't think you're getting a book on salad, because no. I don't just eat salad. I eat a lot of other things besides salad, okay? So, thanks for watching. And wait a minute, if you don't want to buy my ebook, show me some appreciation and just buy me a matcha for, you know, giving you a good recipe. It will be greatly appreciated and I will love you for it, okay? Let me send the love out to you. There it is. Okay. Thank you for joining me in the Veganlicious kitchen. If this is your first time here, please don't make it your last time here. And what I want you to do is subscribe, like, share, and comment. But also, enjoy your day. Don't just enjoy your day, you already know. Enjoy life.